Hi students, coming to the next topic, that is a push down automata and context free grammar. So by seeing this video, before that you have to know what is this context free grammar and the push down automata. Okay, so I hope you understand all this CFG and PDA. Now let's see how we are going to convert the given context free grammar to push down automata. So let's take this as an example. This is a given grammar, the production rules are given, so which is a context free grammar. So the starting symbol determines ASA and BSB and the C. So here A, B, C are the terminals and S is the non-terminal. Okay, so that we know that. So here I need to convert this context-free grammar into push-down automata. So before that, how to design a push-down automata? Suppose to design a push-down automata, what you will do? So to design a push down automata, first we need to push the elements on the stack and pop the elements. So we'll do push and pop to accept the string. So this is a method we follow. Okay, for context free grammar to push down automata, what we have to do? To convert the context-free grammar to push-down automata, what you have to do? Simply, first write the productions. First, write the production rules. Whatever the production rules are there, first you write the production rules. And pop. And then pop the elements. So here you are not using the concept push, you are just write the production rules, after that you pop the elements. Okay, so there is no pushing here, only production rules and then you are popping. That then you can convert the given context free grammar into push down automata. So let's start the problem. So first starts with the production. So first thing is I have to write all the production rules and then pop. So these are the production rules that has to be represented in the push down automata. So the first one is I have taken this S. Write the ID. ID is a instantaneous description. So that you have to be right. Instantaneous description is starting state I am taking as a Q naught. Okay. At starting nothing is there. Epsilon. That is a start input symbol is null. Okay. That input I am reading it's a null. Okay, there is nothing is there in the stack. Now the stack is empty. Q0 is a start state. The stack is empty. That is a string. I didn't take any string. This is the we are the start symbol, input symbol. We are taking only the null. Okay, now the stack, top of the stack is epsilon. Nothing is there on the top of the stack, epsilon. Okay, we are working on the input symbol is null. Because I don't know what are the input symbols. I'm just reading the production. So here there is no, for the state A, there is no input symbol and the top of the stack is epsilon. For this Q naught comma epsilon. So here the Q naught is nothing but the state and here the epsilon is nothing but the value on the stack. So starting there is no value on the top of the stack. Now coming to the second. Stack contains, S is a stack contains Q naught. Now the start input symbol is a null symbol. Okay. Now I have taken this S top of the stack. Top of the stack S I placed on the top of the stack. So what is the top of the stack? Write the production rule. What is the top of the stack? The top of the stack that production rule is ASA. So in place of ASA you have to write ASA. Okay. A. Write ASA like this. Top of this stack. So this is just one production rule. Means I am writing only the production rule. I am not performing the pop all operations. I am just writing the rules. After that I take the transition table to convert the context free grammar into the push down automata by seeing this production rules. Next, or you can call the transition rules. Next is S Q naught epsilon. Okay. Start top of this. That is a start, S is a start symbol, S top contains, this is, this time instead of ASA, I am going right the BSB, this is one production. And the fourth rule, Q naught, epsilon, the top of this track may be Q naught, comma, C. Okay, so these are, I have written all the production rules. Production rules. So according to the method to convert the context-free grammar to production rule, first write the production rule and then pop. So I have written all the production rule. Now I start the operations of doing pop, the fifth transition. So here popping is taking place. The production rules, there are no input symbols. Now I am taking the input symbols to pop the stack. S, Q naught. So there was no input symbol. Now I am placing the input symbol A. Okay. And the stack contains the A, Q comma epsilon. So Q1 comma epsilon means the changing the state. So whenever the it is changing the state, the changing the input symbol means epsilon means you are entering one state. It changes the state Q0 to Q1. Okay. Change of input state has to change the state. Now sixth rule. Stack contains, now the new state is Q1. Next time placing the input symbol B. Now the top of the stack contains the B. It changes the state to Q2. Now the seventh transition. S, it changes state Q2. Now the top of this, now I am placing the input symbol C. Now the top of the stack is C. It changes state to Q3 comma epsilon. So these are all the rules. Now take the transition table. Let me write the transition table. Okay, so let's take the serial number and stack state, whatever the state that it is contains it at present in which state, and unread input, that is a unconsumed input that is there in this ID unread input, and what is there in the stack. Okay, and the transition number, which transition number is applying on that, that you have to be right. Transition number. Now start. So starting the state should be Q0. This is the initial state. Let's take a string, unread input string, whatever the string you want you can take, but here I am taking ABBCBBA. This is a unread input string I am taking. Initially the stack is empty. This is the transition one. Okay, the first rule I am applying. Second, okay, second is state is Q0. I, in the stack, I am placing the top of the stack is the start symbol. Okay, this is a, S is a start symbol. The unread input data is A, B, C, B, B, A. So, I use the transition number 1. Okay, because that is a transition 3. Now, in place of S, I am placing the top of the stack as A, S, A. So, which production I have used? Which production I used here? A, S, A. ASA is a second transition. So here the state is similar. Q0 is only. In place of S, I place ASA. The state is Q0 only. The input is ABBCBBA. I had used in the transition state as 2. Now check here. The stack contains A and the unread input data is this similar. So pop it. So popping. Popping means, whenever we are popping, the state is changing here. Okay, if A is there, I need to pop. Epsilon represents the pop. Okay, so now the state changes to Q1. Now the stack unread data is BBCBBA. Now in place of S, just write SA here. So I have used in the transition number rule 5. Now fifth. So here in place of S, I am writing this time BSB. So which rule it is? BSB. BSB is a third transition. Is the state changes? No. State changes to Q0. So now the state is, new state is Q0. BBCBBA. Now S is replaced with BSBA. We are using the third transition, third rule. So same elements are there, B, then pop it. So by seeing the rule, which rule? Sixth. Okay. So this is a transition number 6 we are using to pop. Now the state changes to Q2. So because for input value B, you need to, the top of the stack B, you need to pop it. So I popped it. The state is changes to Q2. BCBBA. Now this is SBA. Now in place of S, I am writing CBA. Okay, in place of S, I am writing, let me write here one more B is there now. So again write BSB. BA. So according to the rule 3, now the state here is the Q naught BC BBA. So here the same elements are there. So pop it. Pop it means the state is Q2 CB BA SB BA. So I using the transition state 6 I have chosen. Okay. So sorry, I have popped it. Now coming to the 9th state. So here C is there. So C means in place of S, I can replace S with the third production. So this is a 3. I can a 4. I can replace in place of S, I can replace with the C. So that is the state is Q naught. That is I have used in the 4. 4 transition state is the Q naught. C B B A. In place of S, I am writing B B C B. So pop it. So by using the production rule 7. So if both are same, C means the state is changing to Q3. Q3 this time BBA BBA. So this time try to pop all the elements. Okay. Using 7. So BB is there. BB means the state is Q2. BA BA I have used in the transition 6. 12. So this time BBA will be cancelled. Again, finally, you reached Q1. Epsilon A is also cancelled. Epsilon reach the final state. So this is how you have to construct the PDE. Conversion of context-free grammar to the push-down autopilot. I reach the final state. So whenever you reach the final state by using the production rules of PDA. So this is a week. First here I converted the context-free grammar into this PDA. These are all the PDA. The problem PDA is this production rules. Okay, push-down automata production rules I converted. Okay, so first write the production rules and then pop. That becomes the PDA. So this part along with this part you call it as a PDA. Push-down automata transitions. So with the help of these transitions, I taken one input string and I had pruned that the given whatever the string I have taken is accepted by applying these rules. Thank you.